of my transition so far and what I've done. So I guess I'll, it's gonna be hard to summarize. I'll go into further detail on each little aspect in other videos. So I guess the main things that have contributed to the transition that I've started so far is hormones. Dermatology, I guess I could describe it as. Cosmetics. And, that'd be three things. I guess voice, kinda, but just not really, barely. That's something I'm trying to get going better. So yeah, I guess I'll probably branch it all into hormones, dermatology, cosmetics, and voice. Yeah, so so as far as hormones goes, I think I might have mentioned in another video, I've been on hormones maybe 3 months, but I'd have to say in the first month I was on such an extremely low dose that I don't know if I can hardly even count that as hormones, so maybe it might be more safe to say that I've only been on it for like 2 months, maybe. I started out taking just like 1 milligram of regular estradiol and like 50 milligrams of spironolactone. I'd first got my medications off the black market because it was taking me forever to get hormones from a doctor here. And I wasn't sure if I was ever going to get hormones from a doctor. I'd heard from some people that it, and living in this area, that it had taken them an entire year to finally get access to hormones. And that was, seemed way too long for me, because I'm kind of at a crucial sort of spot. I mean, I'm 24 right now. I'm just kind of at that point of getting older to the point that hormones would be less effective, but still kind of young. So it was really prudent to me that I get hormones right away, as quick as possible. A year would cannot be tolerated. So, and it was kind of interesting because I was all paranoid and everything about ordering hormones overseas, essentially what I thought was illegal. But after my third shipment, one of my packages had a sticker on it saying that customs had opened it, and but I still got the package. Everything was in there, all the pills. And I guess I found out that like 4 or 5 months before I started I guess it might have been 4 months that I started hormones, but again, extremely low dose, so the first 2 months were extremely low dose. And yeah, so, and I mean, on the first shipment I made, I bought such, I just bought the tiniest amount that I could buy, because I was so unsure about this company. First of all, I wasn't even sure if they were going to even send anything. Maybe they were just going to take my money. And if they did send something, maybe it might just be placebos and not have active ingredient in it at all. so I didn't want to waste too much money. It was worth the risk, because I wasn't sure if I'd ever get hormones from a doctor, or at least not in the next year. I'm going too far off track. Catch my train of thought. It turned out that it wasn't even illegal for me to get these hormones 4 or 5 months before I made my first order. The government of Canada, I live in Canada, had changed the laws so that you could buy a 3-month supply of certain medications that weren't on a certain schedule called Schedule F. And estrogen and spironolactone are not on that list. So that was a huge relief. So yeah, on my third shipment, it said customs had opened it, but they shipped everything, and I was thought I just got lucky. But no, it seems it's entirely legal. However, in Canada here, like I've mentioned in my other video, particularly in Saskatchewan, government covers everything, so it's far, 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 far cheaper to get hormones from a doctor here, because you don't pay anything, really. I think I pay like $2 for like all my medications. Stuff that would cost hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of dollars without the government covering all my medications. I can't even imagine. I feel so sorry for you guys, all girls, all in the United States and in these countries that don't cover medications, having to pay all this money, like having to pay money to get blood work, having to pay money to see a doctor. It seems so ridiculous to me. I'm not too huge fan of Canada, but the healthcare sure is nice. I did eventually get hormones from a doctor about 2 months ago. And at about that time, I got more confident in ordering from overseas. My doctor here started me on a very, very low dose. He started me on conjugated estrogen, Premarin, at 0.625 milligrams, which is basically nothing. But I ordered huge amounts from overseas. So I ordered a bunch of like Premarin, I ordered a bunch of like sublingual estradiol, a bunch of like...
Jeez, what else did I buy?
Estradiol Valerate, not the injection, but in pill form. And I bumped up my dose to like between 8 to 10 milligrams of estradiol. I found that at 10 milligrams, starting to mess with my health a little bit. My body temperature was getting really hot, really hot. I was having all kinds of hot flashes and stuff. And I'd also jacked up spironolactone to like 350 milligrams, which isn't too high, but for me it was too high. Taking all that, my doctor also started prescribing me finasteride, which is an antiandrogen as well. So taking 5 milligrams of finasteride, 350 milligrams of spironolactone, and 10 milligrams of estrogen, it was messing with my health and my mind. Like, I'd wake up in the morning and I'd be dizzy. Like, and I would just like fall on the ground, and then my face and my body would just be covered in sweat. Like, just sweat. Like, I thought I was grabbing the phone and just like so tempted to dial 911 because I felt like I was dying, seriously. Like, my heart was just out of control. it was crazy. But I used all my willpower not to get an ambulance, because if I did that, then they would check my system and go, oh, whoa, you have a huge amount of estradiol, and then probably I wouldn't get any more hormones from my doctor, because he'll be like, oh, he's abusing it, so it's not prescribing anymore. So I don't know whether that would happen or not, but I didn't want to, like, I did not want medical system to know that I was doubling up, for whatever the term is, taking extra hormones on top of what they're prescribing me. Because I want them to trust me so that I can eventually get them to prescribe me higher doses so they don't have to order from overseas, because I don't want to do that. And one important note, from ordering overseas, always buy brand name. Don't buy generic. Generic is so much cheaper, but it has like so much other junk in the pills and stuff that can make you sick and stuff, and especially like most of these overseas pharmacies that don't require prescription are come from a company called Standard Chem and Pharm, which is headquartered in Taiwan, and the tricky thing about that is, Taiwan is still technically a part of China, and everybody knows China has, like, the worst regulations, so, I mean, it's just really bad. I mean, especially Premarin is probably the worst to get as generic. Because I'll have to get into that in another video. That's I'm getting too far off to detail here. So that's where I'm at now. However, after that incident where I kept pushing it, and day after day, I'd just be breaking out like hot flashes, dying in sweat from these high amounts of hormones. So I eventually docked it down a little bit to between 7 and 8 milligrams of estrogen and about 250 milligrams of spironolactone and 5 milligrams of finasteride. And for a while, but that's which stopped the hot flashes to a degree, so they weren't so severe. I guess the other thing is, it still had an effect on my mind. It made it difficult to, think abstractly, to interfere with my higher level thinking. Yeah. Like, I noticed when I was, like, studying for finals and stuff, especially, like, in